Now, debt watcher Fitch Ratings bumps up its outlook on the Philippines to stable from positive while affirming its triple B rating. With us now for more live from Hong Kong is Sagarika Chandra, the Associate Director, Sovereigns Team of Fitch Ratings. Good to have you back on, Sagarika. Welcome to the program.
Hi. Good to be here.
All right. So what got the Philippines the outlook upgrade?
So we've seen consistently good performance on the macro front for Philippines. It's one of, it still remains one of the fastest growing economies in the Asia Pacific region, even though last year we saw a bit of a slowdown of growth. At the same time, we've also seen that the authorities have stuck to a sound macro policy mix, which we think will continue to support generally high growth rates for the Philippines. We expect inflation to stabilize, and we expect the debt, the government debt to GDP ratio to remain on a sort of downward path with these tax reforms that the government has initiated. So looking at all these factors together, the macro story of the Philippines is very strong and it has stayed intact. Also to add the infrastructure program of the government that still remains on track. So looking at all these factors together, it's a credit that seems to be moving in the right direction. And that's really the key reason for raising the outlook to positive and affirming the rating at triple B.
All right, so the economy is headed in the right direction as the outlook upgrade comes, as though a whole world is just grappling with the disruptions of the novel coronavirus outbreak. To what extent has your assessment considered the various scenarios? Should the outbreak stay on for longer?
Right, so in terms of just the impact that we think at the moment on the Philippines from this virus outbreak is relatively less as compared to some of the other credits in the Asia Pacific region. We think the tourism contribution to the Philippines at just less than 3% of GDP shields the economy to some extent as compared to other more tourism dependent countries. However, we do think that if this, it will depend on how severe and how prolonged this virus outbreak would be. But even in that scenario, I think from our perspective, the growth story for Philippines is quite strong. We also think that the authorities have ample buffers in case they need to support the economy on the fiscal side as well as on the monetary front to support stabilization of growth if that were to be required.
So would Fitch stick with its 6.4% full-year target on the Philippines?
Yes, we are maintaining 6.4% for this year, for 2020.
As we're talking about easing, central banks in the region have begun to do just that, just to offset the negative impact from China to Thailand. The Philippine Central Bank concluded it resumed cutting the policy rate last week. But how sufficient is the policy space between monetary and fiscal to deal with the external shocks and the spillovers to the domestic economy?
Right. So for the moment, we think that on the fiscal front, given the fact that the debt levels are not that high, it's somewhere in the range of about 35 to 36% of GDP. When we look at other countries in the triple B category, they're operating at much higher debt levels. So on the general government debt front, we think that Philippines still has room when we compare it with other triple B credits, and it's sort of close to the triple B median as well. And their fiscal deficits have been sort of stabilized at roughly between 3 to 3.2, 3.3% of GDP. And we also think that the authorities are being prudent by going ahead with these tax reforms, which allows them some room to increase spending if it's required without compromising on a widening of the fiscal deficit.
Now
on the monetary front. So on the monetary front, we think that there is some room still. However, we will be tracking, indicators like inflation and credit growth, given that previously Philippines has had some risks around the economy overheating and the fact that the real interest rates are they are still positive, but there's a little less room on the monetary front. However, I think the toolkit that the authorities have, in our view, seems to suggest that they have sufficient room at this point to go in for some kind of an easing to support growth if that were to be required.
Let me bring your attention to the the statement we just flashed on screen, because your report makes a brief mention of the government review on certain contracts here in the Philippines. To what extent might this pose as a risk? Because a lot of the commentary we're getting here from investors, local and foreign, they cite a concern as regards to sanctity of contracts and changing the rules in the middle of the game.
So for the moment, we don't think this is likely to affect the foreign direct investment flows into the Philippines. However, it is something that we would be monitoring. At the same time, we've also highlighted the fact that Philippines' ranking on the ease of doing business has improved in the latest ranking from what it was previously. So at this point of time, we think that in our projections, we still expect FDI flows to remain sort of stable and at almost the same level as we've been seeing in the previous year. So we're not really factoring in much of an impact from this review of contracts into our projections, but it is something that we will be looking out. We will be monitoring it.
Final point, and quickly, what will prompt an A ratings upgrade?
So at the moment, the rating is at a BBB with a positive outlook. From here, for the rating to move up, as we've mentioned in our rating drivers, what we would be looking for is if there is continued strong performance on the macro front, along with macro stability, which is, of course, dependent on the kind of policy mix that the government has, that could be a trigger for a further rating action in the positive direction. And if we continue to see improvement on the general government finances, which includes stabilization or downward debt to GDP ratios, along with an improvement in the government revenue to GDP ratio, that could also prompt an improvement in the rating. And the last one is the structural indicators, where Philippines still continues to lag its peers. So if we see upward momentum on structural indicators closer to the peer median, then that could also be a trigger for a positive rating action.
All right. Sounds like a laundry list of things to do before we get that A ratings upgrade. Thank you for joining us, Sagarika Chandra of Fitch Ratings in Hong Kong.